My name is Barbara Newman, or Barb, and I'm a photographer, as an amateur photographer, and like to travel doing landscape photography. I was a regular photographer doing travel, just traveling and taking pictures for a long time. And when digital came out, it took a lot longer to figure out how to work it, so I took a break in between film and digital. And somewhere along the way, I decided to try again and took classes, and took more classes, and took more classes. And started traveling with it, and it's a lot of fun. I'm a contractor, work doing project management and business analysis and technology. I think it's just something that when I like to travel, I used to go to California, and it was so gorgeous and beautiful. You want to take pictures of Big Sur or this or that, and I found out I had an eye, and people always said, you have a nice eye, so I would take pictures and blow them up and put them on my wall, like everyone else does, and it was my souvenir of a trip. And somehow I got more serious, and when I signed, I wanted to go to Iceland for Northern Lights, and that was my first big workshop. And when you're somewhere at night, standing outside with a camera for hours on end, you learn. You just keep taking pictures, and you adjust, and you learn, and it was great. Part of it is being in the moment. People don't think of that. They think you're hiding behind a camera, but I found it to be the opposite. Because if I went to Iceland on my own without the camera, I would have looked up, and I would have said, oh, how pretty. And 2 minutes later, I would have left. But with the camera, I'm out there for hours. And I get to look at the sky and see shooting stars and see Milky Way and see, the Aurora Borealis and all this stuff that I never saw before. So there's a peaceful moment about it, or hours about it. And I've also met a lot of people, so there's the social aspect. People from other areas that I meet up with to take pictures that we keep in touch and we try to organize and see if we want to go to the same places. So it's kind of fun. It's a very expensive hobby. You sell pictures here and there, but there's so many people doing it now, it's actually becoming very popular. When people are retiring, they're starting to get expensive cameras, and they are doing, signing up for workshops. It's a great way to see national parks or to travel. Nature is definitely my strong point, landscaping, but also nighttime. So I realized I just went to Yosemite, and it was mostly sunrise, sunset, so it's about lighting. But I realized I missed not having any night shots, like the moons and the stars. So we actually did go out one night and try it, but there wasn't enough light. There was no moon. So I realized that there's a mood to photographs that have night in it. It's something people don't get to see that often, because we don't spend time outside, especially being a city person. So I realized I want to go back to doing more night photography, but I'm also trying to learn portrait photography, just for me personally, not for something to, for friends, just to help them out. Iceland, the Northern Lights every night was an experience of a lifetime. There were four women that had taken it together. We were the only ones in the class, and it was, for all of us, it was a wow moment. Every time we went outside, whether it was morning or night, for the Northern Lights or for the morning light, it was just wow. I kept calling it magic. It's magic, it's magic. And then the other one was Milky Ways. So Milky Ways in Arches National Park was outrageous. I never would have seen it. So it was great. It's inspirational landscape photography. It's from March 1st to March 31st, and there'll be around 30 to 35 photographs. Haven't quite decided, depending on how many big ones I bring in. And I'm having a reception on March 8th from 6 to 8 for anyone who wants to drop by and just talk to us, talk to me and other people that are around. That would be great. One of the men that I worked with at Harvard, Francisco Isaza, is a classical Spanish guitarist, and he's played at a few of my other exhibits, and he will be joining with a classical guitar, and he's wonderful to hear. I've done a few in the past, but I was working at Harvard with project management and noticed a lot of empty walls, and I asked if I could exhibit, and so one of my exhibits is still up there. It's been up there over a year in the science building, and then I also had one at the School of Education for a month. There's a photo of morning, it's actually the morning sun at Mesa Arch in Canyonland, Utah. So I was out there doing the Milky Way at night and stayed all the way till the next morning, because there's a very small space and a lot of people try to get those same photographs, so it's, believe it or not, it can be aggressive. So just stayed there all night till the next morning and took shots at first light. And that's the part that people don't understand. They think, daytime photography would be great because the sun's out, but it actually washes it out. So it's first thing in the morning. So that photograph is from Arches National Park, Milky Way. Again, Milky Way is some of my favorite shots. The ice cave. This was a birthday gift. I was in Iceland for my birthday and asked if I could take a picture of a cave. They are caves that are there for a very short time, and when the snow melts, they're gone. So that's my, those are my photos. I would tell them to pick a place they want to go and look for a photography workshop, whether it's birds you like to photograph, or the sky, or anything, find a workshop, because you learn so much in 1 week. It's incredible. Going to the Smoky Mountains in April, and then from there I'm going to start looking for night shooting, because that's what I realize that's what I want to be doing. Norway was one that a lot of us look at because of the Northern Lights, but it's very expensive. I would like to do shoots of Paris, because that's another favorite place, and there's a lot of light with the buildings, so I might do that. I hope they get inspired to go someplace or to pick up a camera and play. You know, I would gladly help someone to find a workshop if they need that help, because it's, you know, you go to work and you come home, it's great to have something else in your life, so I highly recommend it.